Hi there! This video will show you how to design on full cover and partial cover rigid box dieline templates. While adding your design to the dieline template, it can be helpful to refer back to the full cover and partial cover rigid box orientation guide to see how you should place your design elements. To show you how to add your design to your full cover and partial cover rigid box dieline templates, let's use this PackMojo box as a base and add some additional elements. As you can see, this box has a different color on the interior of the lid, as well as logo and text elements on several panels. Full cover and partial cover rigid boxes are made using pieces of gray board and substrate materials that are glued to the board. Full cover and partial cover rigid boxes have similar builds, with the only difference being that the partial cover rigid box will leave a portion of the base tray showing on the sides. Full cover rigid boxes will cover the sides of the base tray entirely when closed. When adding your designs to the dieline template, make sure not to add your designs to the main board. Instead, full cover and partial cover rigid boxes are made using 4 sheets of substrate that you will need to add your designs to. By referencing the orientation guide, we can see that there is 1 substrate for the exterior of the lid, 1 for the interior of the lid, 1 for the exterior of the base tray, and 1 for the interior of the base tray. Let's begin by designing the exterior of the lid. The top of the lid and the lid side closest to you when opening the box will maintain the same orientation. For designs on the left side of the lid exterior, designs will need to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. For designs on the right side of the lid exterior, designs will need to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise. For designs on the last lid side, which is shown here above the lid top, designs will need to be inverted. In order to achieve a smooth and clean look for the box exterior, there will be a portion of the exterior substrate that will be wrapped around the edges onto the inside of the lid, making it visible from the interior. The interior of the lid will be quite similar, with designs on the lid inside and lid side closest in the same orientation. Designs on the left interior rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Designs on the right interior rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise, and designs on the last lid side inverted. For the exterior of the base tray, designs on the base bottom and the base side above the bottom, which should be the side further from you, will maintain the same orientation. Designs on the base tray's left side will need to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise, whereas designs on the base tray's right side will need to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Finally, designs on the last side, shown here below the base bottom, will need to be inverted. Remember that with full cover rigid boxes, these sides will not be visible when the box is closed. Similar to the box lid, in order to achieve a smooth and clean look for the base exterior, there will be a portion of the exterior substrate that will be wrapped around the edges onto the inside of the base, making it visible from the interior. The interior of the base tray will follow the same pattern as the exterior of the base tray. For designs on the base inside, and base side above the base inside, designs will stay in the same orientation. Designs on the left side will need to be rotated 90 degrees anti-clockwise, whereas designs on the right side will need to be rotated 90 degrees clockwise. Designs on the remaining side, shown below the base inside, will need to be inverted. When you're done designing, double-check it with the Dieline orientation guide to make sure that everything is in the correct location and orientation. To learn more about adding logos, vectorizing text, or embedding images, click on the link in the description or head to our website for more design tips. Happy designing!